Morning children, how are you? I think you are safe at home. Yes, we are safe at home and we have to fight with corona. And I am going to revise the lesson, whatever we learned in the section, and we will go for the continuation lesson. So what is the lesson? Animal life. What is the animals we are seeing in our surrounding? So many are there. Land living animals are there, water living animals are there, and some soil also going to live. How they protect, we learned in the previous lesson. So what is that one we are going to learn is different eating habits. I explained that one also, again I am revising it. What is that? Animals that eat plants or animals. So only they eat plants. What they eat? Only plants they are going to eat. They don't depend other things, only plants, like that grass, leaves, fruits, whatever they get surroundings, some potatoes, something in the soil inside also having that food also they are going to eat. In that cow, horse, zebra, I give an example. Already you know that one. So third class also learned, fourth class also learned, no, fifth also same thing. So but how they eat, I explained. Cow how we eat. The front teeth we eat and back side teeth, it will crush it and afterwards swallow it in region that is important. So, in the way, cow has also eat the food. Now, animals that eat other animals are called herbivores. Which are the animals we are seeing in our surroundings? One another animals eating. So, where we see in the forest, where we see forest. So, in the forest, the animals are so many other. In that, which animal is going to eat other animal? Yes, lion chase the deer. Yes, lion chase the deer. It is going to eat deer. So, it is going to have sharp pointed teeth, which is going to help it to kill, and later on it will tear and eat the tearing teeth. So, this is the lion will eat as well as wolf eat. Next, the birds, eagles and owls eat. What they eat? Eagles and owls. What they eat? Small creatures. What that small creature you will see here in our surroundings? Chicks. Do you know how hen babies are called? Chicks. As well as rats. So, how they will eat? First of all, they catch with the claws. What they are called? Claws. Nothing but legs of the birds. They eat with the claws, catch the claws and eat with the beaks. Eat with the beaks. Beaks means this one. So, this one sharp and when is going to be eaten by bird to that small rat and chicks. So this one will be by eagles and owls. So this is about carnivores. Next, the third variety, animals that eat both plants and animals. What they eat? Both plants and animals. First of all, we will give example, humans. Who's that? Humans. Nothing that ourselves. What we eat? Plants and yes, other animals, goat, fish, egg, hens, that all we eat, no? So that's why we are saying as humans also omnivores. So bears, you know no bear? Yes, it will eat plants as well as fish, which is the other side of the water. And it is going to live in the polar region, in the ice, it will search the fishes and eat the fishes. So that's why this animal is known as omnivorous. Ducks, you observe ducks near your yes, where is the we go to parks, there we observe. So there when we see the ducks, what it is going to eat? Small fishes and grass also eat. So this one did by ducks, that's why we are saying known as omnivorous. And fowls also one type of bird. Birds also, it also going to eat same plants and animals. So these are the different eating habits of the animals we learned in this part. And I will continue about how we are living. How we are living, how animals are living, how surrounding is air is there, how we are living we learn. different methods of breathing. Yes, once more your nose. Oh, you can't breathe. Why? If you not have air, you will die. So we know that. Yes, we know that. But just keep your near the nose, one finger, observe it. The air is going inside and coming out, air is warm. So when we breathing in, breathing out, the air is going in, coming out, we are thirsty. So where are not we are breathing? From the nose. From the nose onwards, where will it go? It goes to lungs. It is one of the process for the breathing. This is the known as respiratory system. In the humans, this is known as respiratory system. Humans, mammals. In order to stay alive, animals have to breathe continuously. Oxygen from the air, air is used to release the energy from the home. Carbon dioxide breathed out during the exhalation. So here we are humans are how we are breathing through the nose. And here our nose is going to take the air inside. So this taking inside the air is called inhalation. What it is called? Inhalation. And when we going to breathe out air, it is called exhalation. What it is called? Exhalation. So this process completely is known as respiratory system. Inhalation and exhalation. When we are inhaling, what we are breathing? Oxygen. What we are breathing? Oxygen. And when we are breathing out, what the air is coming out? Carbon dioxide. Carbon dioxide. How we are breathing with nose? So here we are having two holes, which is the nose. We are having two holes that are called nostrils. To the inhale air, whatever the air is go to holes are. So that is inhale air is called inhalation, which is the gas is going oxygen. In our air is a there. That one is only we are breathing. So that is called oxygen. And breathing out is air is called exhalation. Gas is carbon dioxide. So here some animals also we will learn. Some animals breathe through lungs. Mammals, birds, reptiles breathe through their lungs. So who are they? Mammals. Reptiles. What is the reptiles? Which is the animal? Crawl on the floor. Crawl on the floor, crawl on the walls, they are called reptiles. Yes. Next, birds. What are they? Birds. What are they? Birds. These are going to breathe through lungs. How they breathe? Through the lungs. They have two lungs, which are connected by a breathing tube is called nostrils. Breathing in holes in the nose. Air is breathed in through the nostrils and fills the lungs. The large lungs become big when the air is enters. So already I will explain you how the nose is breathing inside, breathing out. So now yourself only once like this, if you breathe, what happened? Like this breathe means your stomach completely going inside and breathing out means you are coming as it is position. So here what happened, internal organ is there. That organ got their nose, one pipe is there and lungs are there. And in that one more there, diaphragm. What is there? Diaphragm. Which is the, in this picture I will show you. See, this is the diaphragm. So this diaphragm push the air. When we breathing air, when we breathing air, what happened? Here, this one push it down. When we breathe down, it pushing up the air. So carbon dioxide pushed by diaphragm And when we take in that we are observing inside and it is extended exposure. So this diaphragm we learned in the previous class only. So this diaphragm only makes us to push the air up and down, and as well as lungs also absorb the oxygen. That one going to be pushed the diaphragm down, and when the carbon dioxide breathing out, that time this diaphragm is going to be up in this one. And some more there, I'm showing you what is this. Yes, earthworm. What is this? Earthworm. What is this? Earthworm. Do you see an earthworm? Yes. Now you can see this rainy season, so many small worms in the soil. Do you see in the soil what they will do? They go deep inside the soil and come up. They go deep and come up. So that is the main the earthworm, very fertile land. The earthworm is known as the friend of the farmer. Who's that? Earthworm is a friend of farmer. So when we see the earthworms in the crop field, what it is going to do? It will go up and down, do holes in the soil completely crop field and make the soil fertile. So some animals breathe through moist skin. So the earthworm, how it will breathe? The earthworm breathe through its moist skin. How it will breathe? Moist skin. See the earthworm, how it will breathe? Moist skin. Skin means? Yes. Here, our skin having holes, you know, no? When we observe, you having hair, pull your hair on the, which is your skin part hand having, what you observe, small holes are there. Which is a form, there is a no holes on the skin. So that skin help them to breathe the air, which is the frog also do, same way, earthworm also breathe the skin. So frog is going to live on the land and in the water. When it is on the land, it is going to breathe with the lungs, and when it is in the water, it is going to breathe with the moist skin. So does the frog? Yes, when it is in the water, on the land, the frog breathes through its lungs. So we understood from this how the earthworm and how the human being is breathing. So this is the respiratory system. How it is happening? Once again I will explain you, and I will show you picture also. So here human being is the human. So this human is going to breathe with the nose. How he will breathe? With the nose. So this is the nose part. So these two are nostrils. What do you say? Yes, nostrils. These are two holes are nostrils. And nostrils, what you do? It will push the air through inside. So this is the windpipe, which is our neck having, that is known as windpipe. So this is the way how the nose is breathing. Inside is called oxygen, that is gas is absorbed inside, and this one pushes into lungs, and carbon dioxide breathed out by when we eat. Carbon dioxide breathe out. Breathe out. Breathe in. lungs. And we will learn some more animals in the next section. Thank you, children. Be safe at home.